Welcome, scholars. I'm Pastor Paul Steinberg, and this is our chapel worship. Our theme this year is Speak, O Lord, based upon the story we have this week. And our response is, I am ready to listen. A reminder, as we worship, don't just watch this, but participate. When I invite you to say something, say it back to me. Reminder for older scholars and adults, if you're there, it really helps everyone when you participate as well, and you'll get more out of it. Later on in the chapel worship, we'll have some songs. When you see the words on the screen, if you know the music, please join and sing along. Let's worship our God. Grace to you, Hope Scholars. Grace to you, Pastor Steinberg. We worship in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Please join me, fold your hands, and read these words of prayer with me. Dear faithful Lord, we praise you for being the Word and speaking to us. Help us listen as we start this school year. Open our hearts to learn about your Word. Open our minds to learn about your world. Send your Holy Spirit to change us by what you say. Amen. Amen. Join me in our key Bible passage. The Lord is trustworthy in all he promises, and faithful in all he does. Psalm 145, verse 13. This week, we've been looking at the virtue of diligence, which is God's power for you to focus on your work. Really important at the beginning of any school year, but especially when we're starting digitally, it's tough to focus and concentrate with a computer screen. And having people spread out, it's tough for teachers, it's tough for adults, it's tough for scholars. And as I look at this last week, I tried, and sometimes I was focused, but I didn't do it perfectly. And so we get to take all that lack of diligence and give it to Jesus today. We're going to confess that we haven't been perfect, but hear that we are forgiven, children of God, because of Jesus. Join me in reading the part marked All. Dear God, I am sinful. I do not always focus on my work. I deserve only your punishment. Forgive my sin because of Jesus. Listen to our loving God who gives us good news. God loves you and forgives you because of Jesus. Jesus died to pay for your sin and had diligence in your place. As God's children, he now gives you power to live for him. Amen? Amen. Please join Mrs. Mayo in singing this song.
I've got peace like a river in my soul. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river.
God's message for you today is listen to good news. Make use of those ears that God has given you. Our Bible story as we start the year is the call of Samuel. In our virtuous diligence, God's power for you too, focus on your work. Samuel was a young boy, similar to some of the age of our middle school scholars, and he learned in this story that God was calling him. Now, that was a special thing. It didn't happen very often. Even in the Bible, God didn't normally directly speak to people. He can do that, but he doesn't normally do it. Instead, he uses God's word, and he speaks his message as you read it or as somebody shares it with you. Samuel, in the story at night, got called several times, and the key thing that we noticed was Eli taught him that the right attitude, when God wants to speak to you, you want to be all ears and you say, "Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. Because God is a great God who knows everything and he has good news for us, and we are as servants, we want to listen. We want to listen because he tells us we are his children. He tells us how to live to be blessed. He tells us great things that we won't hear anywhere else. And as we start this school year, what a great application. We're going to listen to our teachers and our adults, and we're going to listen to math and history and all those great things. But most importantly, we listen to the first C of Christ. Well, let's think about that a little bit. I mean, whom do you listen to? Whom do you listen to? Do you listen to everyone? I hope not. I hope not. There's a lot of people with a lot of bad, mean, wrong, incorrect words. There's a lot of bad stuff going around. Maybe you noticed that. It's all kinds of people saying all kinds of things, and they say different things. You can't listen to everyone, and you should not listen to everyone. Otherwise, you're going to get some real hateful, wrong, messed up messages. You have to think about who you actually want to listen to. You can't always not hear that they're making noise, but listening is something different. Do you listen to trusted adults? Not every adult is good. Not every adult has good messages for you. You can't trust them all. But the ones you can trust, maybe it's a parent of yours, your teacher, maybe it's somebody else, an aunt, a grandma, an uncle. Maybe there's certain people you know when they speak to you, you can trust them. Maybe it's a pastor you have. Maybe it's somebody else. You can trust them. You know you've seen their character and they love you. And because they love you, you know, I really want to listen to them. They have good things to tell me, even when sometimes they have to tell me I need to fix something or change something or I need to work on something. They tell you because it's true and because they love you. The most important person to listen to is God, though. But God often speaks through other people. How do you listen to anybody? How do you listen? Well, you want to stop what you're doing and focusing, right? Right now, if I'm speaking to you and you're actually typing away or doing something, right? You pull out your phone, and as you're talking to me and I'm like this, you don't think I'm listening, right? Or maybe I've got, you come up to me and you're talking to me and I got these stuck in my ears and I'm like, you can see I'm kind of jamming out a little bit. I can't really hear you very well, right? When I'm walking, listening to music and someone says, hey, I can't hear him. Or maybe I'm just always grabbing. So one of my friends gave me a little treat and if I was like, doing this, all those things can distract me from listening to you. And I might be happy to do that if I really don't want to listen to you. I might just be happy to eat some candy or look at my phone. You get rid of other noises, you turn things off, get those earphones out, and you look and you focus on that. And then more importantly, you really engage your mind. While you're listening, you're not thinking about, well, what am I going to say? What else am I going to do after this? But you're thinking, what are they saying? And either in your mind or out loud, you actually paraphrase, which means you say what they said again. Maybe you tell them back and say, well, what I heard you saying was this. And maybe you're giving body language and you're coming close to them and listening. And maybe you listen very well by asking questions. Maybe you're doing that in class where it's tough sometimes with the computer. But when you listen, did I hear you say this? So what was this instruction? I ask a clarifying question. That means I'm actively listening. And when it comes to God, we want to listen that same way where we get rid of everything else. Like maybe in this chapel, you're doing this because you got everything else turned off and you're focused just on this. It's kind of tough, but you're listening. And you're thinking, what is Pastor Steinberg saying? What does this mean for me? What's he talking about? And you're being active and listening. That's how you listen, when you listen well. And when you listen well to God, you hear some pretty awesome stuff. He tells you, first of all, you are his child. He says, because of what Jesus Christ has done, you're my child, I love you. That's great to hear that. I can hear I love you from anybody, anytime. When my wife tells me, when Mrs. Steinberg says, I love you, I love to hear that. I love to record and hear it over and over. And that's what God tells you. He says, I love you, you're my child. He also gives you instructions on how to be blessed. Sometimes the way we want to do things and the way we want to live isn't good for us. And God loves us enough to say, hey, don't do that. And he talks about sins and how we don't show love to people and how we can use our words to hurt people or our fists to hurt people. And he tells us all the things he wants us not to do and all things he wants us to do, not because he just has a bunch of rules, but because he loves us and wants us to be blessed. It also tells us about our renewed future. We can feel the brokenness in the world, and God says, heaven is going to be an awesome place I'm giving to you for free because of Jesus. Look forward to that. We won't have any of this brokenness, right? And God really tells you everything you need to hear. All the news that you need to hear. Some people have said the Bible, B-I-B-L-E, is the basic information before leaving earth. You get what you need to know. But what God doesn't tell you is everything you want to know or false information. He doesn't tell you how to earn heaven because you can't. God already loved you in Jesus. He doesn't tell you there are many truths, like it's okay, follow God any way you want. He says there's just one way. It's my way as proclaimed in the Bible. Listen to me, it's Jesus. And ultimately, he doesn't tell you everything you may want to know. You have a lot of questions, maybe a lot of what if questions or why questions or how this could be part of God's plan, some of the tough things we're going through right now. How can this be if God's in control? God doesn't tell us all that stuff. He just says, I'm God, I love you, I've saved you in Jesus, trust me. Kind of tough, but the more we listen, the more it helps us get through these difficult times. And God's most important message that we really want to listen to, that we don't want to turn away from and get distracted from, is this, that Jesus Christ lived perfectly in your place. He died on the cross and rose again. You're going to hear that over and over again. You can't hear that too much. That's how you know you're a child of God, loved and saved. Loved and saved 100% by God's grace. That's the news. That's what I love to listen to. So let's review. The call of Samuel, the story that you went through this week, teaches us that God speaks to us, normally through the Bible, that we're blessed when we listen like willing servants, as Samuel said. And finally, God tells us many things, both law and gospel, bad news and good news, but it's really all good for us. And we're so glad that in our school, we can hear it all. It's good for our hearts and souls. If you want to listen to God, let me hear you say, Amen. Amen.
Speak, O Lord, as we come to you to receive. Take your truth, plant it deep in us, shape and fashion us in your likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. Teach us, Lord, full obedience, test our thoughts and our
Please say John 3:16 with me. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16. Fold your hands, pray with me, and then respond as it says on the screen. Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for always speaking to us. Forgive us for all the times we have been distracted and not focused on your word. Help us listen to you and also listen to the trusted adults in our lives as they share their messages and your message with us. Help us go forward in this school year. Lord, we pray that you would help COVID disappear, that you'd help people listen to one another in our community, in our country, so they can love one another. And Lord, guide us all and give us confidence as we go forward. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. God is faithful. The Lord is faithful. Fold your hands again and read with me the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Put your hands up towards our God and receive the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen? Amen. Thanks for worshiping and joining us for chapel. I look forward to seeing you again, whether that's live streaming, recorded, or in person. Following this slide, I also have another song. If you want to listen to one more song, it'll finish us out. What talks about how the Lord guides us. It's our precious Lord guiding us into the future. May God bless you this week.
the night draws near and the day is on.